Welcome to Lights Out with Louise. I'm Louise and tonight's story is Clean Up. And I cannot wait to read this story because their other book, Look Up, was my favourite story of last year. This story is just as important and is all about saving our ocean life. So let's see if we can learn what we can do to help. I can't sleep tonight. I'm too excited because tomorrow, me, my mum and my big brother Jamal are going on holiday to see Grammy and Grampy. It feels as though we've been packing forever, but at last we're ready to go. I'm gonna be fist bumping with a turtle, dancing with a dolphin, high-fiving an octopus, and surfing the waves like awesome Imani Wilmot. Did you know? Imani Wilmot created the first female surf competition in Jamaica. How cool. As soon as we arrive, I give Grammy and Grampy a huge hug. My grandparents are the best. They run a whale watching tour and have an animal sanctuary at the back of their house. I can't wait to help out. Grampy tells me we never touch wild animals unless they need to be rescued or cared for. And then it's time to surf. Grammy is really good. Mum and I build a huge sandcastle. Jamal is too busy to help. Oh no! A baby turtle has washed up to the shore and it's all tangled in plastic. I pick up the baby turtle gently and take her to Grammy and Grampy. They can fix this. Grammy says she will do what she can and takes her back to the sanctuary. Plastic is ruining these islands, Rocket, says Grampy sadly. We save as many creatures as we can, but many stay away. People used to come here to see whales. We haven't spotted one in a long time. He leads me down the beach. Feels as though there is more plastic than sand. I feel really sad. We need to do something. But what? The next day at the beach, there are people playing in the sand, swimming in the sea, eating ice lollies. But all I notice now is plastic. Surely they can see it too. I need to let everyone know. Did you know whales eat the plastic and it makes them sick? Did you know nearly half the rubbish in the sea comes directly from careless people? Did you know there are over 5.25 trillion pieces of plastic in the ocean? Soon we have lots of new friends who want to help. It's a cleanup crew! As the day goes on, more and more people join in. We spend the whole day cleaning the beach. Even Jamal helps. The cleanup crew is amazing. And soon the beach is clean! But now, what do we do with all the plastic we collected? Teresa, one of the cleanup crew, has a brainwave. My mum is an artist. We could get her to make something. Yes! Teresa's mum makes some awesome bins for the rubbish, and the whole cleanup crew makes the front pages and TV news. No one will forget why we need to clean up. Everyone on the island wants clean beaches. Everyone on the island wants clean water. Everyone on the island wants to save the sea life and bring back the whales. The next day, Grammy and Grampy have a barbecue for the whole cleanup crew. The smell of Grammy's special sauce is wafting around the island. And best of all, while everyone's talking and laughing and eating, Grampy and I release the turtle we rescued back into the sea and watch as she swims away. She's all better now. And I just know that one day the whales will come back. Did you know one day you are going to change the world, Rocket? And here is some information on how you at home can help clean up the beaches. And I'll pop those bits of information in the caption below the video. So I hope you enjoyed the story today. I hope you learned something. And maybe all together we can make some change. So, I hope you enjoyed that story tonight, and I hope to see you soon for another bedtime story. Good night.